Hi, I'm John Crivella. I'm a hematologist working at the Princess Margaret Cancer Center here in Toronto. I'm one of the investigators in the lymphoma group, so our job is to develop and deliver treatments to patients with lymphoma, not just in Toronto, but for Ontario and across the country.
And I'm Rob Laister. I'm a staff scientist here at Princess Margaret Cancer Center, and I work closely with John translating research laboratory findings into the clinical setting.
When you look at why you should want to support research, I think a couple of important themes really come out here. Firstly, there's a lot of research going on out there, and you could be asking, what does anyone else add above what Big Pharma is able to do? And what I'd say there is, Big Pharma is very focused on the things that they know about, and the goal is ultimately to help deliver therapeutics to patients. And that's a very important goal, and academic research has an important part to play in that. But when you think about how many discoveries have actually been successful, many of them haven't started out of Big Pharma, right? They've come out of small academic groups, they've come out of committed research groups that are very interested in understanding the biology of a disease or asking a question about how to make something more effective. And it's less commercial in its goal ultimately in the beginning. And so it's very important that you give researchers the opportunity to ask those questions in a way that they're just important answers that will hopefully one day lead to a treatment that can impact a patient.
And just to follow on that, from a basic scientist perspective, while there are many therapies out there and that have, have been successes in the clinic, there's still so much that we don't understand about the biology of the disease. We culture cells in flasks and we put them in incubators, but these are just model systems that don't really recapitulate what a lymphoma tumor is like in vivo. And so some of our other projects are actually geared towards developing novel cell culture systems where we can really replicate what the lymphoma tumor is experiencing in the body, and that will allow us to better understand the biology of those tumors, and hopefully that will give us better insight into what pathways we should target, what drugs we should use, or how cells like CAR T might fail in these patients.
Yeah, so how will we measure success? I think, I'll echo what Rob has said that, the teamwork component of this is really ingrained both in the culture of the group as well as the institution that we work at Princess Margaret. And so, the success is going to be measured by the team doing the work and at least trying to move the field forward somehow. But ultimately, the goal of all of this is to be able to take observations, get them to patients, give people new opportunities, because that's really what we need for patient care.
Kyla is a master's student in our lab, and she's demonstrating how to culture cells that we use for drug development here at Princess Margaret Cancer Center. The red liquid is fresh media that she's adding to the cells to enable them to grow so we can do drug testing and other downstream assays. The cells are then placed in an incubator that is environmentally controlled to provide the conditions for proper cell growth. Here, Joan is centrifuging some samples that we're using during a protein purification process. The centrifugation will separate the purified protein from some of the other impurities in the sample. Here, Miguel is demonstrating how to load a sodium dodecyl sulfate polyacrylamide gel. We use this technique for proteomic analysis from lysates of lymphoma cells grown under a variety of conditions with or without drug treatment. This is a very important technique that we use routinely in the laboratory. Here, Marika and Lily are looking at some data that's indicative of protein expression in various lymphoma cell lines. The protein they're interested in is Bruton's tyrosine kinase, which is the drug target for the small molecule ibrutinib. This is a machine that we use for metabolic analysis, where we track how different lymphoma cells use different metabolites under different conditions. The thing that really drives my research focus is training the next generation of blood cancer researchers. You know, having the trainees in the lab and getting them excited about the work we do is extremely important to me. Then, you know, being able to work in close collaboration with John and get the basic science ideas that we have towards clinical applications, that's what really is one of the best parts of my job. I'm Rob Laister. I'm a researcher at the Princess Margaret Cancer Center, and I'm an LSC-funded researcher.
I'm John Cravilla. I work at the Princess Margaret Cancer Center in Toronto, and I am an LSC-funded researcher.